So we're gonna be covering some passing today. Okay. I'm more known for my guard game because I came up with a technique called the worm guard, which maybe some of you have heard about. I've used it on a bunch of high level guys. From 2014 to now, I've been using it and sort of like messing up everyone's day with it because it's a very unique position, and me and some of my training partners are the only people who actually know how to like properly apply it. However, I don't want to start with that today because it can just be a little much for beginners to work into. However, there's tons of resources online through all, like if you follow any of my social media links, you can find tons of stuff about it. As well, if you came here just to learn worm guard, like specifically really want to learn just about that, feel free to ask me any questions you have about it, and I'd be happy to just like take some time while you're drilling to show you some of the moves and work over it if you already have been training that. However, those of you that haven't started it, we're going to work on something else for right now. So, we're going to be talking about passing the guard. We're going to be using a slightly different thing that I've been doing lately that I really like, and I think people should start using it. And it's the idea of passing with a cross grip on the leg, okay? So let's just talk about some of the basics of passing the guard first. As some of you may know, passing the guard entails me getting around his legs and getting to a dominant position like side control. I have to somehow navigate my way past his legs, pin him down into a position like this, where his legs don't have control over me anymore. That is called passing the guard, okay? If I'm still in his legs in any way, if I have my leg here, this is still guard, right? He has half guard on me. I have to find a way to get past that before I can get to my dominant position and have to count as a guard pass, okay? Most of the game of jiu-jitsu is either passing the guard or playing the guard, right? He's playing guard, I'm trying to pass his guard. He'll take whatever grips he wants to sort of maintain a guard. Right now, I just got like a Delahiva hook in control of my ankle. Usually, you follow that up with like a sleeve grip or possibly a collar grip or something like that. Okay? Most of the time, you can keep this collar grip for now. So, most of the time when you're passing the guard, the main thing you need to worry about is your posture and thinking about what grips he has on you. Okay? He has these grips because he's using them to control me, to try and stop me from getting past his guard. Okay? As I move around, he can follow me with his grips, using his legs to sort of off-balance me, extending me away, and possibly set up attacks of his own. So the very first thing you have to do when you're dealing with passing someone's guard is you have to address his grips, okay? So whenever someone has a grip on you, you have to break that grip first. It's gonna make your life a lot easier. If you just try and pass through his grips, you're doing yourself a disservice because you're really fighting him in his game, what he wants you to do, okay? So it's very easy to actually break the grips, usually just putting both your hands on whatever the grip is and pulling away. Even if it's on the leg, the same sort of thing applies. You can just grab it and sort of rip it off. Because you have the advantage of using both your hands to break his grips. And you also have gravity on your side to put pressure and help you in these situations, okay? So that's sort of some of the basics of how it works, right? And then that's how the game starts. Is I'm trying to get past his legs, he's trying to regain his grips to control me, while I'm trying to put him in progressively worse and worse positions using pressure and movement to try and get around his guard. At the same time, he's trying to recover his grips, work back to a position where he can use all his limbs against me, right? So I have the advantage of gravity on my side. I can push down into him, but my legs are planted on the ground, whereas his legs are up in the air. He can use his legs and his arms. So his advantage is he gets to use all of his limbs to attack me. My advantage is I have pressure. Most of the time, the guy on top has an advantage as far as like they will usually end up passing the guard if there's equal skill level between the two, just because being on top is usually better. And you should always be fighting to get on top. Even if you like to play guard, you consider yourself a guard player, which I consider myself a guard player, my goal is to always come on top, okay? Coming on top is too powerful a position to ignore. You have to do that. You have to try and fight to get on top. If you stay on bottom the whole time, whether it's a competition or even in training, being on bottom, no matter how you look at it, is losing, okay? That's one thing that a lot of competition guys at lower belts like purple and blue don't really understand yet. Being on top, being on bottom is losing. Being on top is winning, okay? So, we're just gonna go over a simple guard pass first. First thing I'm gonna do, and I'll talk more about the grips as we get into it, but just for something to drill and get us all warmed up, we're just gonna do this first, okay? I'm gonna take my hand, I'm gonna grab a cross grip on his knee here, like this. Actually, not his knee, below his knee, but on the pants. Okay? I don't want it too low, I don't want it too high, I just want it right in the middle. Now I'm gonna walk to this side, and normally you might put your knee here in his thigh like this to sort of put pressure. I don't like to do this because it's giving him control over me. He's playing what's called reverse Delahiva guard here. It's giving him control. He can attack me from here. He can invert under. He can go to X guard, deep half. He can do all sorts of attacks. So my job is to try and take him out of these offensive positions. Okay? So I'm going to grip like this. And instead of going right here with my knee putting pressure, I'm going to bring my knee to the outside of my hand while still maintaining this grip here. Like this. Okay? It's very important. If any of you can't see, I keep this grip on his pants here, but my knee is on the outside. You all right there?
Yeah, I'm just making sure everybody can see.
Okay, okay. Bring his knee over the top like you're defending, yeah. So normally you'll end up in this position here. He's gonna start bringing, this is called knee shield. He's put this knee in between me as a shield and a frame to prevent me from putting pressure on him, okay? And that's fine, that's totally expected and normal when we get into a passing position. But this is a lot easier to pass than the position you were in earlier, like De La Hiva or reverse De La Hiva, anywhere that he has like strong grips on me with his legs. So I have this grip here. He's putting pressure against me. I'm trying to drive into him. This hand isn't doing anything yet. But what I want to do is I want to grab his collar here. Okay? From here, I don't start walking around. I want to drive more into him, put more pressure on this leg. As he continues to push off of me, trying to keep his weight off of me, that's going to allow me to slowly start to walk around while still putting pressure. You'll notice I still have my hand on his bottom leg here. This is fine for me, and it's really good because I don't want him to bring this knee in to recover. He could bring this knee in, then he's going to be able to recover. So I want to keep this arm straight away. You'll see I put my weight on top of his thigh. I'm trying to drive this knee down. When it's up like this, it's strong. He has good posture here in his leg. He can push me off of him easily. But as I slowly move around, I'm trying to drive that knee down, putting pressure with my shoulder on top of his knee. Okay? Until it almost becomes sideways like this. You'll feel it when someone's doing this to you. You'll feel very out of position and like you're in danger of getting your guard passed. Okay? From here, all I'm going to do is continue walking all the way as far as I can, keeping my head on his stomach the whole time, and I keep this grip. As I get further away from this leg, I'm not really going to keep that grip anymore. It's not important. I just want to go all the way to north-south. And control. Okay? The key detail here is gripping across like this. The second most important detail is bringing my knee to the outside. This is something you don't see very often, but it makes a lot of sense because think about this. If I have this grip here, and I start to put pressure like this, my own arm is blocking my knee. So I can't continue to put pressure and pass. I'd have to let go and then readjust. So you're just sort of thinking ahead a little bit by putting your knee on the outside of your arm. Still maintaining the same pressure. Here, it's okay, whatever he does to get in front of me here, because all I'm doing is driving in. See, I lift my butt up. That's so I can get over the top of his knee. If I just drive in forward into his knee, he still keeps this rigid defense here. But look, as I drive my hips up, it allows me to get over the top of his knee and then drive down on top of it, forcing it across, okay? Once I put this pressure and his knee is across, that's when I start circling. Once I get about halfway, I need to start moving my head towards his stomach and then completing the 180-degree movement, okay? So we're just gonna start with that. What's up?
Do you look for baseball choke from there or loop choke from there?
Usually when you're like passing the guard, the first goal is to just pass. Position before submission, right? So if you're in the motion and he somehow turns and you feel like you're gonna lose the guard pass, if you see an opportunity to go for a choke, you obviously can. But really, realistically, it's better to just focus on trying to solidify the guard pass. And usually it's not the first guard pass that gets them, it's the second or third. So you have to learn how to like link them together. So if he's defending and it gets to the point where you feel like you're gonna lose the position, it's better to like switch to another guard pass or back out and go to like a Toriano rather than go for a diving choke, which you would kind of have to do at that point.
Okay.
So yeah, unless you're just a submission killer and you just submit everyone. You have a sick loop choke, go for it. But yeah, that's what we're gonna work on. What's up? Sure. So the full movement will look like this. Cross grip. I do a little shuffle step, drive my knee forward. He's gonna defend by bringing his knee in front and I reach over the top and grab this collar. I lift my hips in the air, so I'm driving downwards. As I drive downwards, I circle. Once I get halfway, I turn my head and put it more towards his stomach, posting my weight on my head. I let go of the collar and start to reach towards around his body, just get whatever control I can, and go go all the way to north side.
Okay. Any other questions? All right, guys, let's try it. On three. One, two, three.